Okay, guys, now we will look into something called as the dummy variable set. Okay, so far we have dealt with dummy variables, that is basically your Boolean variables which can have only 0 and 1s, and by default we had continuous variables. Okay, now from 2 to unlimited, in between there is one particular type of variable, that is your categorical data. Okay, so categorical data has certain number of values, like in this particular example, it has 1, 2, 3, 4 representing which year are you in. Okay, so based on the year you are in, you have to take 1, 2, 3, 4, one of these values. Now let's calculate some really interesting function, that is your attendance. Okay, so the attendance of a student in the particular college has to be beta, let's say this, take, let's take this as x1. Okay, now here x1 can take the value of 1, 2, 3, 4, and beta 1 would be, let's say, the coefficient here, which would, let's say, be 6.2. okay, or should we take plus? From my experience, I'll take it as minus, and alpha would be 100. Okay, so from the experience or from the data which I collected, this regression model gives me the result that for x1 equals to 1, okay, that is the first year, the attendance of the student is 100 minus 6.2. That is, it's 93.8. Similarly, for the second year students, it's minus 12.4. That is 87.6. You can do these calculations yourself. I'll just write like 6.2 times 3. And in the fourth year, students don't care it at all. So we will have 24.8, that is 75.2. Okay, it's absolutely correct. The model is perfect. So what we get from this particular thing is that when we study all of these things together, right, the x1 variable can take the value of 1, 2, 3, and 4. And that basically tells me that in first year, the attendance will be 93.8, second year 87, third year 81.4, and fourth year, we will have the bare minimum of 75.2. Okay. Now, the thing is, if you see, this is how we use the categorical variable. But is there any other way of studying this thing? And that is where the dummy variable set helps you. Okay. The thing is, dummy variable set do not appeal a lot, maybe because of its name, or that because it can only have two values, zeros and ones. But now remember this particular number, that is, it's 93.8, it's 87.6, it's 81.4, and 75.2. Okay, and just remember that the beta for all of this is fixed. Every year on an average, it goes down only by 6.2%. So now let's remove all of this. Try to think of any other way in which you can use the value of 1, 2, 3, 4. Is there some way of doing that? Using dummy variables, we have another option. That is, we have four variables, x1, x2, x3, x4. And you have to say whether this is 0, 1, this is 0, 1, this is 0, 1, this is 0, 1. As you know, first year x1, second year x2, third year x3, fourth year x4. So basically, I'm saying, am I in first year? Am I in second year? Am I in third year? Am I in fourth year? One of these will be 1. Okay, so let's say I'm in this, so all the other values go 0. Now let's assume that y equals to alpha plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus beta 3 x3 and beta 4 x4. Now plus error. Now the thing is that whenever I choose this particular thing, the beta 2 will come up. Okay. And this x is, let's say, 75 now. Okay, then it will all be plus, 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 plus. Now, if you see here, the thing is, this model looks perfect, but it will not work in reality. And the reason for that is there is a need for variation. Until unless there is a variation, you cannot build a model for constants. Okay, that much I think everybody knows. If you see x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4, it will always give you 1. That is a constant. So if you remember, in the last lecture, we had an assumption, the second assumption, that all of the variables should be independent. All of the observations should be independent. I should not have any relation among the observations. But the thing is that for any students, all of my observations summed together is just one. So they are not independent. To make sure that this data, and that is how the system will look at it, to make sure how this data can be handled, because there's nothing wrong with the data and it's a genuine analysis. And I really think that most of you would like to have this analysis with you so that you know what your peers are doing, you can maintain your attendance accordingly. For that, what we do is that we reduce this particular thing from here. So now my y cap equals to a cap plus beta 2x2 plus beta 3x3 plus beta 4x4 plus e. Now, let's say that I get some values here. This is 75 plus this will be 5.2 x2 plus 3.1 x3 minus, or let's say plus 0.5 x1 plus error. Now, what are these values representing? That is what we have to focus on. So whatever we have reduced from here, that particular thing is called as the baseline category. Okay. So what we did is that we assumed this particular thing as the baseline. Okay. So assuming that the coefficient for this is zero, we will start moving ahead. That is, we will say that, okay, from the data side, to just keep it a bit more realistic, I will change the values to negative of these. Okay. And this one will be 90. Okay. So what I say is that if I assume the baseline category zero, that is in the first year, all of these will be zero for sure, right? Now all of them are zero and I have the value y equals to 90. So my first year guys go 90% of the times. Now the second year will have 5.2. The 5.2 is basically telling me a minus 5.2 that they will go 5.2 less than the base year. That is my first year. So it will be less than that. That will be 84.8. Similarly, they will go 3.14 less than the first year. Here it will be 90 minus 3.14. That is 86.9. And in the last it's 0.5. That is 89.5. Now, this is hopefully a much more serious institute in which the seriousness actually goes up. But the key thing that you have to see here, and that was the key observation I wanted you to have, is that here you have a fixed beta. Here your beta varies. Okay. And you have only three beta. You don't have four beta. The reason is that one of the beta has to be taken as a baseline. So that will not represent here. The reason why we can't have all four of them is that if we have the sum is a constant, they will have some interdependence on each other. If three of them are independent, fourth will be dependent, which we can't have. Secondly, these are with respect to that one thing that you have missed, that is the baseline category. Finally, and this is the key thing, the variations can be independent. Here, what you see is that 6.2 is the amount each of the values have to increase or decrease by, right? So it will only go 6.2 from here to here to here. Whereas in this particular case, it will go 5.2, then 3.1, and then 0.5. So while representing categorical variables, you have two options, this one or this one. Now, the equation for this was much more simpler, right? But the good thing is, fortunately, you don't have to do the calculations. Now, is it always correct? Not necessarily. Correct to choose this. Both of them are correct. To choose, if you know that the beta will be constant, for example, in a government office, let's say, you know that per year it will be 7% increment. You know that the beta value has to be somewhat constant. You can keep beta and use this particular method. But if you don't know the changes from x1 to x2 and x2 to x3 could be drastic, then in that particular case, you use a set of dummy variables to represent the categorical variable. Okay. And that is why dummy variables are not just used 0, 1, not just used to represent the dummy variables, the Boolean values, but also for categorical values. Okay. This is actually a very important concept because you will, if even if you don't come towards dummy variables very often, you will not have 0 and 1 kind of data in your set, but you will definitely have a lot of categorical data. So please do consider watching this video again. If you have any doubt, put it down in the comment section. Yeah.